Good evening, everybody. Good time to talk about Royal Challengers Bangalore, as today is the first World Cup game between England and South Africa going on. Before I start, I just like to ask one question. How many of you followed this year's IPL? I won't ask how many of you supported RCB, how many of you supported any team for that matter. Yes, we are very fortunate to have a fan base like RCB in Bangalore. They are emotionally connected to our team like no other business. And this results in a huge amount of responsibility on us. The reason being, we have to be consistent in our communication and true to our values. Very, very, very critical. When we started this journey of RCB in Bangalore, even we were really fascinated to understand what is happening. Because the fan following just grew. We were not able to understand what made them tick. Then we spoke to all the fans and understood what is making them relevant to our cricketing fraternity and RCB. If you look at this super fans, I'll use this word super fan. Super fans are guys who are heavily invested in the team. They wrap their self-esteem in a team. I'll give an example in terms of, or before I go into the example, I can tell you saying that super fans go to any extent, see for example Sukumar here, any extent to do anything for our team. See this. You know, this is a Chennai Super King super fan who was reacting to the loss when Mumbai Indians defeated Chennai Super King. These guys are really invested in the team. And this is what, and kids day and age, they are like that. And they are bordering obsession, I can say even addiction for that matter, in terms of. So who are the super fans? What influences them in terms of being a super fan? A super fan is mainly influenced by maybe their parents who are already a super fan, or their sibling who are also a super fan, or they have introduced the stardom at a very early age. So what is resulting in this? What it really breaks down to one single human behavior, which is group. Biologically, we all want to form groups. Simple as that. The reason being, if you see hundreds of years back, we used to form groups, we are smart enough to form groups and hunt for survival. But now we don't have to form groups to hunt. So what do? We group around interspaces. And sport is one of the biggest interspaces in India. That is the fundamental of fandom here. And what happens? What happens if you look at from that point of view? And this also helps in giving a lift to their self-esteem and other things. Take, for example, our super fan here. Did I miss Sukuma? Can just go back. See this guy. This guy's name is Sukuma. He's RCB super fan. He's from Bangalore. Like any one of us. If he's sitting in this crowd, you won't even notice him. But what is he up to? He's been hardened fan for last 12 years. He has been visiting Chinnaswamy Stadium every single game. And check out his attire. He spends around 6 hours getting this done before the game. I asked him what makes him do all this stuff. One is his passion for the team RCB. Other one is he wants to be distinctive. So when I spoke to him in depth, I understood one critical trait. One is the need for optimal distinctiveness, which is nothing but he wants to fit in and he wants to be distinctive. And all the fans at any given point of time would have crossed that line, being distinctive and wanted to fit in. And if you look at Sukumar, we'd be up there in terms of being distinctive. So that is the reason what is driving these guys. And if you look at other fans in terms of the normal fans, not like super fans, they are also is craving for being distinctive. If you see, in terms of painting the face, having a new jersey, but they are also trying to find that equilibrium where they can land on distinctiveness and fitting in. That is where it is. So on fandom, what I want to say is, if you see when our society is divided, where we can't even reach out, or it is becoming harder and harder to accept other person's point of view, it is fandom which is acting like a bridge. Otherwise, why on an RCB game, all the watering holes are full? And what happens there, you're meeting strangers. Strangers are socializing with you, having beer, having a drink. And when a wicket falls or an RCB wins, they give high five and hug and give a hug. Why is that happening? So fandom is very critical for anything for that matter. But the question is, this fandom doesn't happen all of a sudden. Click of a button, we get fans. No. So how did we at RCB build this huge base of passionate fan? One thing we clearly understood. In India, cricket is a religion. And hence, if you have to build this brand called RCB, we need to resonate and talk to young India. The philosophy of young India should come alive through RCB. Not aligned to regional, establishments in terms of. We are not here to talking to regional ethos here. We are talking to young India. So, but how did we do that? Let's see that. We dug deep into culture to understand what are the conversation happening and what can we leverage. From there, we understood there were two broad narratives. One is making it narrative, and one is, I'll come to that in terms of what the second narrative going to be. Making it narrative is nothing but classical youth discourse. Nothing but transcend your past. Push your own boundaries. You have realized this, but your potential is this. Go do it. Push yourself. Leave your mark. It is nothing but overcoming narrative. It is all making it big in the world. The benchmark comes from outside the world. That's when, for example, India pushed and got Miss India, Miss Universe. It's all pushing boundaries. A karo, hey ho jayega. Do BCom, do this, you'll get that. So that is the narrative all about. But now what is happening? Indian youth is moving beyond that. The new narrative is called a figuring out narrative. What is figuring out narrative? Figuring out narrative is where life has no template. There is absolutely no template in life. Earlier there was set template. Now there is absolutely no template. They're craving for movement without direction. What are they looking for? They're looking for living in an expanding universe. What does it mean? They want to visit more places, more experiences. They want to dream more. That is where it is. And hence, what is happening? There is no roadmap for life. There is only a road trip awaits you. What does that mean? There is no signpost to guard the youth in India. There is no Google or there is no formula. They need to experience life and move on. But along with this comes a lot of anxiety. When there is no roadmap, there's no to tell you, do this, you'll reach there. You have to find your own way. There's a lot of anxieties comes along with that. What are those? This culture privileges risk-taking and finding your own way. But absence of this roadmap and template also results in both liberation and paralyzing. Because there's no safety net for you. The onus is on you. So hence, there's fascination on one side and the fear of unknown on the other side. And what did we do? We at RCB looked at this cultural opportunity and defined the role of RCB in a life that is liberating us from the fear of consequences as we break the template and venture into the unknown. This is what RCB's role in life is. And what is a philosophy? What is a belief system? The belief system is breaking out of template. When there is no evidence, no precedent, go ahead. When you believe in a philosophy, be unafraid to walk alone. And the belief is, when you are unafraid to walk alone, over a period of time, the world will rearrange around your belief system. That is critical. And today's youth is doing that in India. And that is how we created our brand philosophy. And manifestation of that is this, play bold. This is the manifestation of that. Now, what we have discussed now here is, what I have narrated now is, how we understood the cultural narrative and anchored our thought. But the critical is execution. One is, how do you bring this entire philosophy alive? Critical for that is our team. The construction of our team. If you look at our construct of our team, there were three core members. Chris Gayle, Virat Kohli, and AB de Villiers. And these guys know only one way of playing cricket, that is playing bold. If you look at any stats, highest score, which is RCB, highest number of sixes, RCB, any big, what do you call, number is with RCB. So one of the stuff is like we spoke about having a right product. This is the right product for manifesting the philosophy of play bold. What do you do next? Next was, we did a really, really bold step, which is emotionally connect with our fans further. What do we do? Let's hear this.
I'm not here to speak about the team, but about the team behind the team, which is all our fans. And today we're doing something very special for all our fans. So I'm going to show you what it is. It's a tribute to the support that the fans have given us over so many years, and their relentless support regardless of our performances. This is a jersey specially designed for the fans. I'll tell you what it is and what it symbolizes. So you can see it's an RCB jersey, but it's got number 12 at the back, which means all the fans are officially our 12th man, all of you together. So, and we're also retiring this jersey number for RCB, and it'll always stay with the fans. So you are officially from today our 12th man, who will be supporting us regardless, and it's probably the most important member outside the 11th. So this is a tribute to all of you, and thank you for your continuous support over so many years, and we'll continue to entertain you and hopefully go an extra step ahead this year.
So
thank you.
We pushed boundaries in terms of, we retired jersey number 12. That is where the emotional connect comes in. When we say there are 11 players on the field, and the 12th player is not a player himself, but it is a fan, that's a big statement to make. That is where the connect comes in. What did we do next?
Making a debut on Mr. Nag's show.
I'm a huge Nag fan.
Let's talk about your relationship.
Yes.
With me.
Yes.
Love me or hate me.
Love me or hate me.
No, not hate, it is a yeet.
Yeet.
What do we do in terms of this? We started RCB Insider, maybe I think so 6 years back. The reason is, all the fans, they get enough cricketing content. On-drive, pull shot, that, this. But what they want, or what they're looking for, real and relatable content, which is authentic, which is behind the scene. And where the players talk openly, and we can also talk openly in terms of. And RCB Insider is all about that. If you look at RCB Insider series after series, we are hitting million hits per episode. Each episode is maybe, I don't know, 3 minutes. I know you have viewed this RCB Insider, 3 minutes. Each one of this, a million hits each, without spending a single penny. The next big initiative, what we did was, launched our own mobile platform. What we felt was, currently our fan base was split. Facebook has some, Insta has a few, Twitter has other bunch of guys. So what we felt was, we had to create one unified platform from where our fans could directly connect the players. They could start buying tickets, they could start buying merchandise, everything they could do here. They could create communities there, chat among themselves. And this was launched last year, last couple of months back. In 2.5 months' time, we got around a million user base on this. Big ticket, and we have big plans to further this initiative in terms of making it really big. The other big initiative is this. I know we have noticed this. A couple of fans came back and told us, we are very, very big fans of RCB, but we can't come into the stadium because we have pets, and we can't leave our pets at home. We said, challenge accepted. We created a pet lounge, and we called it Dog Out, not Dug Out, Dog Out. And this was a big hit in terms of, really, really big hit. Thank you. And now the ask is much bigger. Now they want, the pet parents want one stand to be converted into the pet stand. We don't know whether it will be possible, but we will try. Other one big initiative is this, RCB Diva. 6 years back, we started this property called RCB Diva. We want to talk about women, women behind the cricketers. Nobody knows them. They also have identity. They also have done something in life. For example, AB de Villiers' wife runs a successful business in South Africa. Nobody knows about this in terms of. So we created this property called RCB Diva, where we brought this cricketers' wives, girlfriends, all these guys, our friends, and started to talk about them and what they're doing and stuff like that. Last but not the least, this other big initiative, RCB's agenda into Green Bangalore, Green India. RCB Chinnaswamy Stadium is the first stadium in India to be carbon positive. We give back electricity. Apart from that, what we have done is the jerseys the players are wearing, these are from the trash which we have collected from our stadium. We collected the trash, recycled it, and made it as a jersey. So what I'm trying to say with a few of these initiatives are in terms of, one is understanding the culture, what is underneath India, what does young India wants. Other one is in terms of understanding that and bringing that to life. So what RCB's fan following is not just because of 2-3 initiatives. It is because of the concerted effort and also linking back to culture. That is critical. So I want to leave with 5 learnings here. 3 P's and 2 R's. We have chained the 3 P's. And this is what we follow at RCB and we follow at Diageo. One is purpose. Always bring the brand alive with purpose. What is the philosophy? What is the belief system? If there's no purpose which is rooted in culture, that brand won't succeed. You should have a brand which is rooted in culture. Second one, personalization. In this day and age, that is very critical. For example, the app launch, what we have done, it is clear signs of personalization. We are giving them what they want. Second one is in terms of the retiring 12th man jersey. That is also a sort of personalization. We are giving to the group saying that this is yours. That is critical for us. Third one is partnership. We can't do all this stuff on our own. That age is over where one agency does everything for you. That is over. There is enough resources out there who are ready to partner. Please go partner. The fourth one is reach. India is massive. India is massive. We need to reach consumers and build consumers. So if you look at, there's one initiative what we do, what is called as Royal Challenge Bowl League. It's a cricket, gully cricket league, box cricket league, which we do. We go to some 60 towns and have this box cricket tournament happening. So slowly we are embedding our brand in interlands of India. And the last one is renovate. Please, we don't get bored by seeing our communication, but consumers get bored. So keeping the purpose alive, your manifestation should keep changing every 3 years and 4 years. So these are the take from RCB from my side. Thank you. God bless.